And during this presentation, you will realize that there are many opportunities maybe for us to contribute. And it doesn't require a very costly foundry. Maybe some equipments could be purchased, and maybe materials could be purchased, and maybe we can contribute in organic electronics. It is also called as a plastic electronics, stretchable electronics, flexible electronics. So there are so many, you can say, synonyms for this word. Plastic electronics, flexible electronics, stretchable electronics, wearable electronics, many names are there. Okay, and it's very interesting field. I got the interest in this field somewhere in 2009-10, and of course that I have not made any contribution, but I keep on reading, and I basically that add content to my slides and my material, and wherever I get opportunity, there I familiarize participants with this particular field. Okay, so let us continue with the presentation. Okay, first of all, I have included various references from which this entire presentation is prepared. So approximately 100 papers I have read, from these 100 papers, this entire presentation it is prepared. Okay, some of the references I have highlighted using red color. Those papers I like most actually, and they are very interesting. You can look at these references in detail, and you can read these papers yourself also. And in this 1 hour session, it won't be possible maybe for anybody to make you expert in the field of organic electronics or whatever that field is actually. Okay, I'll just give you I'll try my best actually to make you familiar with the organic electronics. What is organic electronics and what are the opportunities there? Okay, so first three slides, it's basically references, and these are really standard papers. Maybe one should look at it. Okay, I've included some content from this particular paper. It's 13.56 megahertz RFID based system based on organic transponder. This paper, it was published in IEEE Solid State Circuit in the year 2007, and one entire book is available on organic field effect transistors from CRC Press, and some other books also might be available. Okay, this is the second slide of references. This is the third slide of references, and so many other papers also I read. And these two papers I recently read. One actually, the title is Flexible and Printed Organic Transistors from Materials to Integrated Circuits. It's a review paper. It's published in Elsevier Journal of Organic Electronics, and it was published in 2019. And there is another paper, it's published in IEEE Transactions on Electronic Devices in the year 2017. And the title, it shows that maybe that if you read it, you will get current status and opportunities for the organic film transistor technologies. Okay, these two are the recent papers. That other papers are that maybe somewhat old actually, that not very old, but maybe that 2011, that before they were published before 2011-12. Okay, so that is about references, and these are various people who contributed in the preparation of this presentation, who helped me in PhD student. He was PhD student at IIT Bombay in Electrical Engineering Department, and currently he is with Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company. And another person is Sri Prakash Tiwari. He was also PhD student in the year 2008 in the Department of Electrical Engineering at IIT Bombay, and currently he is a faculty at IIT Jodhpur. Maybe that you can look at his webpage, and he is doing excellent work in organic electronics. Then Dr. Sanjay Prajapati, he is currently is an associate professor in EC department at LD College of Engineering, Ahmedabad. And Professor Hetal Bhatt, he helped me somewhat actually in collecting all this material. He was associate professor in EC department at SPC Visnagar, and currently he is running his own firm in the field of electronics. Okay, the outline of this presentation, first we'll look at that what is the motivation for organic electronics. Okay, then we'll have a little bit about the introduction, then some applications, then OTFT, that is the organic thin film transistor. Similar to MOSFET, here the transistor is called as a OTFT, organic thin film transistor. So we'll look at its structure. Okay, that modeling I have included as a backup slide. Then we'll look at some circuit design styles. Okay, that then one RFID example and few display technologies. And I presented it at various places, and I'm sure it won't be possible to complete within a period of 1 hour. Even I asked Professor Bhaveswamy that can we maybe have more time. He said that we have to wind up at 6 o'clock. Presentation. So wherever that will be at 6 o'clock actually, there will be stopping. And I will share entire presentation with all of you. Maybe you can read yourself. Okay. So okay, let us go ahead. First, let us look at a motivation. What is the motivation for organic electronics? Okay. Okay. First, actually, that I'll just brief you about what is organic electronics. Say that we all are familiar with the silicon-based electronics. Okay. So. Basically, to develop any electronic circuit or electronic system, okay, you need three type of materials. One is the conductor, the second is insulator, the third is semiconductor. So, first of all, actually, to develop organic electronics, basically, organic electronics it uses organic materials. So you should find out organic material which can provide you properties of insulator as well as semiconductor. Okay, and the at very low temperature and the cost that is low. Okay, so that's why this particular field it is also called as a if you have to explain.
Sorry to interrupt you, sir.
Yes.
Actually, your audio is somewhat breaking. So, can you sir kindly guide, sir?
Rajesh, sir, if you can just stop your video, I guess the audio quality will automatically improve.
Just a minute.
There is some bandwidth. Yeah. And then during the question answer, we can turn on the video.
Yeah, just said that this platform is slightly new to me. I'm familiar with Microsoft.
Yeah.
Okay, now I think my video that is off.
Yes.
So
okay.
Now
just start.
I'm using broadband Wi-Fi. It has 50 megahertz speed, and I don't know that why that this issue is coming. So now audio, is it coming properly or that not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Audio is okay.
Okay.
You have to yes, yes, yes. Correct. Done.
Okay. 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 So now, see, basically, organic electronics, it uses organic materials. Okay. This material, they have to behave as conductor. Okay. That some of the materials behave to as insulator, and other materials have to behave as semiconductor. So if you can find out organic materials which shows properties, all three properties, conducting properties, insulation properties, and properties of the semiconductor, then whatever the electronics you build up using these organic materials, it is called as a organic electronics. Okay, so now once the materials are found out, lots of research work is going on in finding the right kind of organic materials. Maybe that during my presentation, you will come to know that you will come across various complex names of organic materials. Okay, now once the materials are found out, then the job is not done actually. You have to fabricate devices. Okay, that various devices, electronic devices, transistor, LEDs, diodes, sensors, that various kinds of devices you have to fabricate, or you have to simulate, and you have to optimize their performance. Okay, so once the devices are ready, okay, then actually you can design various circuits. Okay, and you can design digital analog circuits, and you need to optimize those circuits for the best possible performance. Okay, and once the these circuits are somewhat designed, okay, then actually you can build up some complex electronic systems for large scale applications. So this is what the end, maybe you can say, part of organic electronics. First of all, one has to find out organic materials with those properties of conductor, insulator, and semiconductor. Then one has to maybe fabricate or investigate various devices and optimize performance at the device level. Then one has to design various digital and analog circuits. And once the circuits are designed, then the complex systems could be explored. Complex electronic systems could be explored. So this is what the entire path of the organic electronics. Okay, now let us go ahead. Okay, now let us see what is the motivation behind organic electronics. See, if you see that we all are interested in reducing the cost of the electronics. Maybe if you look at the mobile phone, that nowadays the mobile phones are available, they are just like mini computer actually. That they have almost each and every feature that. And if you compare its cost with the cost of the mobile phone, which was available 10 years before, or even before that actually, you can say that cost has reduced drastically. Okay, so that how can we reduce the cost of the electronics? The normal method actually, which is followed in the silicon-based electronics, that is increasing packaging efficiency by downscaling technology. Okay, if you look at silicon-based electronics, earlier the device channel length was in the range of the micrometer. Now it has gone down to less than 5 nanometer actually. So within the same silicon volume, you can put a large number of circuits. Okay, that increases packaging efficiency. Even actually, you can put more number of features, and the cost will come down there. So this is what the approach it is followed in the silicon-based electronics. Okay, now the second approach is to reduce the cost of electronics. That is, maybe one can work on larger but cheaper substrates. This is silicon wafers. They are somewhat costly actually. So compared to maybe that costly substrates, one can actually go for larger and cheaper substrates. Now in organic electronics, second approach, that is what favored. Organic electronics, it favors the second approach, that well, cheaper substrates are used. Okay, cheaper substrates means actually the plastic based substrate, or that glass based substrate, or maybe some other less costly substrate. Okay, so printing on inexpensive substrates like glass, plastic, laminate, metal, it is possible actually. This organic electronics, it is also called as all printable electronics. You can actually, some of you might be feeling surprised that this electronics, it could be printed. There are inkjet printers available with which entire electronic circuits, it could be printed. Okay, and it is printed on a plastic substrate. Okay, so it is possible to print electronic circuits on less costly substrates like glass, plastic, laminate, metals. Okay, and that's why this organic electronics, it is also called as a plastic substrate. And when the substrate is plastic, actually, it may be whatever the properties of the plastic it could be possessing. So then you will get the properties of flexibility. Maybe towards the end of this presentation, I'll show you example where the display it is developed, which could be bent. Okay, the reason is that display it is developed on the plastic substrate there. Now using high-resolution printing method down to 100 nanometer, like micro-contact printing and other more conventional printing techniques like inkjet, cream, offset printing. There is another printing method, reverse offset printing. So using this printing method, sir, you can actually print organic electronics, and you can quickly develop some prototypes. Low-cost, large area, flexible electronics can be produced. So basically, see, maybe organic electronics, it uses organic materials. These organic materials, it could be printed on less costly substrates. And for the printing purpose, you can use various printing techniques like inkjet, screen, offset, reverse offset printing. And low-cost, large area, flexible electronics can be produced. So that is what the motivation is. Now, if you look at some introduction part of this particular topic, in 1977, three scientists, Iger, Shirakawa, and McDiarmid, got a conductive polymer by doping polyacetylene with arsenic pentafluoride, and that has opened up new era for electronics named organic electronics. So this is somewhat complex name for we people, for chemical engineers, for them it may not be new actually, and it may not be, might not be feeling complex there. But for we people actually this is slightly complex, polyacetylene with arsenic pentafluoride. So these three scientists, they come out with conductive polymer, by doping polyacetylene with arsenic pentafluoride, and it has opened up new era for electronics, which is named as organic electronics. And they are awarded Nobel Prize in chemistry in 2000. Now, organic electronics, it competes with inorganic devices for applications which need mechanical flexibility, large coverage area, inexpensive mass production. So see that maybe once you will become familiar with organic electronics, you will realize that organic electronics, it can't completely replace silicon-based electronics. There are certain properties where organic electronics it is seriously lacking. So maybe that it can't replace all silicon-based electronics. But there are wherever that you need mechanical flexibility, wherever you need large coverage area, wherever that you are in need of inexpensive mass production, then organic electronics it can compete with the inorganic devices. Am I properly audible? Am I properly audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No
Okay.
problem.
Now major advantage of organic materials is that they can be deposited. So that's why it is called as a printing electronic. Onto substrates at low temperature, thus providing for compatibility with plastic substrates. See, plastic substrates actually it has a melting point close to 250 degrees centigrade. To realize any circuit on the plastic substrate, you can't use conventional silicon CMOS processes. So to implement flexible circuit on low-cost plastic substrates, directly applying conventional silicon CMOS process is not a feasible solution because the required process temperature it is close to 800 degrees centigrade, and that exceeds the melting point of most plastic substrates. Maybe those who are familiar with VLSI subject, they might be knowing that to fabricate high quality this SiO2 or dielectric material, it needs temperature close to 800 degrees centigrade. And the plastic substrates, they are having a melting point close to 250 degrees centigrade. Okay, so conventional silicon CMOS process, that maybe you cannot straightway apply the plastic substrates because plastic substrate, it will melt. Okay. Okay, so let us go ahead. Now, unfortunately, organic materials, they are very sensitive to ambient conditions such as oxygen, moisture, light, which degrade and consequently change their properties. These organic materials, they are very sensitive to environmental parameters like oxygen, moisture, light. Okay, and they change their properties. If they change their properties, that means that you cannot develop reliable electronic systems. But this was a problem 10 years back. Actually, now slowly, all these problems are getting solved. Okay, that maybe extensive research is going on to improve performance of organic materials. But this is used as an advantage also that because as they are very sensitive to oxygen, moisture, light, maybe you can develop very good sensors. Which can sense all these parameters, oxygen, moisture, light. So organic materials or organic electronics, it has a huge amount of applications in the sensor area. A very high quality sensors could be developed using organic materials. Okay, and extensive research is going on to improve performance of organic materials that you will realize when we will go through the presentation. There are giant players, including IBM, Lucent, Oda, to nearly 75 research groups across the world are working in organic electronics. The field of organic electronics focuses primarily on the issues relating to the organic thin film transistor device, which forms the basis of organic integrated circuit. See, maybe for any electronic system, you need transistor. So the primary focus in organic electronics, that is to develop organic thin film transistor. Okay, so lots of research work is going on to develop high quality organic thin film transistor. Okay, you may find n number of papers on organic thin film transistor. It is also called as organic field effect transistor. So there are two this acronyms. One is OTFT and another one is OFET. Organic field effect transistor, both are referring to same device. It's a transistor device, okay, which is developed using organic materials. So lots of research work is going on to develop high quality organic thin film transistor. Okay, now this is a some comparison between various technologies, and we are mostly interested comparing CMOS and injected, or you can say that that organic thin film transistor, which can be printed with the inkjet printer, okay, or inkjet technology. So if you compare this CMOS technology with the injected organic TFT, there are some other technologies. If you are interested, you can read about those technologies. Amorphous SI TFT, it is used quite a lot in the display application. Okay, so let us compare CMOS with the injected organic TFT. So if you see that the process temperature in CMOS, that is close to 1000 degrees centigrade, whereas in case of the inkjet, it is close to room temperature. Okay, process technology here, you need lithography for patterning. Okay, and in case of injected organic TFT, we don't require lithography. Okay, earlier people, even actually in the organic electronics, lithography was used. But nowadays that maybe slowly that they insist that everything should be possible to print using inkjet printer or some other printer, reverse offset printer or some other printer. Feature size, in case of the CMOS, nowadays it has gone down to less than 5 nanometer. Okay, whereas in case of the organic electronics, small channel length device, that is not possible to fabricate. We'll see what is the reason actually. Okay, so here that device length, it is in the range of the micrometer. Okay, 50 micrometer or maybe that more than 10 micrometer basically. Substrate here it's a silicon wafer. Here you can use glass or plastic substrate. Device type, in case of CMOS, it is possible to realize both devices, P-type as well as N-type, whereas in the organic PFT, said before 2015-16, only P-type device was possible. Okay, but now we'll see that even N-type device is also possible, but still the performance of the N-type device, it is not as good as P-type device. So that is one of the problems with the organic electronics. So that's why you need to change your circuit design. Supply voltage in case of CMOS, even it is possible to design CMOS circuits below 1 volt, 0.5 volt, 0.4 volt, it's possible to design. Whereas in case of the organic PFT, the supply voltage which is required, that is quite large. But now this problem is also partly solved. We'll see that some circuits are even designed at 2 volt, okay, 2 volt or 3 volt. Mobility, that is a very serious issue. In case of CMOS, mobility of charge carriers or electrons, it is close to 1500 centimeter square upon volt second. Okay, whereas in case of organic PFT, 10 years back it was in the range of 0.01. Okay, but now it has improved to at most say 5 centimeter square per volt second. Okay, and if mobility is less, the driving current would be less. If the driving current is less, then the charging and the discharging rate would be less. So organic circuit can't operate at very high frequency. So that's why I said that organic electronics, it can't replace silicon-based electronics. Okay, but there are certain applications, particularly low frequency applications, where one can use the organic electronics. Cost per area, in case of CMOS, it is high. In case of organic electronics, it is low actually. Okay, lifetime, in case of CMOS, it is very good. In case of organic electronics, it is poor there. I'll show you some characteristics of very simple circuits, and you will realize that if you go through the circuit or if you change the voltage in one direction and if you traverse it back, you may not get the same characteristic. It basically shows the hysteresis. Okay, so that is not a, it's not a good sign there. Okay, but all these problems are maybe people are working to solve, and partly these problems are solved, and maybe within some years you may find certain applications where organic electronics that is the only solution maybe all these industries would be using. Okay, so this is a comparison between the CMOS technology and the organic electronics. Other technologies are also included. If you're interested. Applications of organic electronics. Even in the silicon technology, we use organic materials for photoresistor, okay, for patterning purpose. We use negative photoresist and positive photoresist. That is nothing but actually organic material. As I said, that these organic materials are very sensitive to environmental parameters, so they have huge applications in sensors. Chemical sensors, pressure sensors, biosensors in healthcare, okay, because of the flexibility. Maybe in healthcare, these biosensors will be used quite a lot, and they are maybe in certain applications, they are already there in the use. IoT, that Internet of Things, that. Okay, that they're all because there may require sensors, and for the sensors, you can use the organic materials. Okay, so in IoT domain, you can use organic materials or organic electronics or organic sensors. Radio frequency identification tags, RFID. We require RFID in the huge quantity. Okay, that maybe if you visit any mall, that all the products might be having RFID tags. Nowadays, it is used in vehicles and at various places they are used in baggages. Okay, so we require RFID tags in huge quantity, and if cost is low, then they can be used in a very large quantity. Okay, so and organic electronics, it offers low cost solutions. So that's why that in RFID, organic electronics, it is having a major application. And flexible sensor scanners, display technology. In certain maybe applications, you need to bend display. Okay, and it is possible to bend display provided that the substrate actually it's a plastic substrate. So that's why that organic electronics, it has huge applications in the display technology. Smart card, e-paper, foldable solar cells, and flexible displays on low cost plastic substrates can be 95% cleaner and 90% lighter than conventional LCD displays on the glass substrate, and it is mechanically stronger also there. The another applications that is on demand rapid fabrication of electronic circuits. Okay, that is a cost effective prototyping. Suppose you come out with some novel circuit and you want to immediately realize that circuit, then maybe using inkjet printer or maybe some other printer, you can print that circuit and you can test it. Okay, you can measure various performance parameters. So immediate prototyping, immediate cost-effective prototyping is possible in case of organic electronics. Shall I continue that, Bhavesh?
Yes, sir. We just take photograph at last. Okay. So you just continue, sir.
Okay. Now there are various issues with organic electronics. Okay, that some of the issues I've already mentioned in the comparison. Only P-type device. Very low mobility, large supply voltage, performance degradation and sensitivity to environment. N-type OTFT, it is one order or lower in carrier mobility than P-type OTFT and often becomes unstable when exposed in the ambient air for a prolonged period. Okay, and as N-type OTFT, it is not possible. Okay, nowadays it's somewhat possible, but maybe the 3-4 years before it was not possible. So then you can't design a CMOS type of circuit, and that will result into high static power consumption. So that is one of the issues. As these materials are very sensitive, lifetime is short. Okay, as the mobility is less, the driving current would be less. And that's why that the charging and the discharging rate would be lower and the slow operation speed. Another problem that is to increase the current. Okay, if mobility is less, you can increase the device size. Okay, device width. And if you try to increase the device width, if you increase the charging and the discharging current, then it will increase the capacitance. As the capacitance increases, it will actually maybe reduce the speed. Okay, so these are certain issues with the organic electronics. Okay, now we need various properties from the organic materials. Then you can realize organic electronics. Okay, so basically we need three properties from organic materials. One is that conductor, second is semiconductor, third is the insulator. Okay, so organic conductors for electronics, they are the PEDOT, that okay, or PSS. Now these are complex names, as I said in the beginning. Polyethylene dioxythiophen, okay, and polyaniline doped with camphor, polyaniline doped with camphor sulfonic acid, is also called as a PANI. These two materials, they are showing the properties of the conductor. Okay, but maybe you will see that we don't use these two materials, but instead of that, either this gold that is used to realize the metal, okay, or basically that gold that is used for the connections purpose, gold or maybe that silver or copper, that is what used for the connection purpose or for the contact purpose. Okay, so these two conductors are not used. P-type semiconductors, okay, that is a P3HT, that is a polypyrihexithiophene, polyphenylene, vinylene, and pentazine. Okay, that these are P-type semiconductors. And there are so many other key type semiconductors. See, lots of research work it is going on to find out good semiconductors, good conductors, good insulators. Okay, so maybe you will come across more names that will go through the presentation. Now, P3HT and Pentasin. Okay, and there are some other that semiconductors. They are basically suitable for the p-type devices. For n-type semiconductors, one can use the fullerene. Okay, fullerene maybe you might have studied. I'm talking for the students maybe in the 11th or 12th standard. That if you look at science book, maybe that you may come across fullerene. Okay, fullerene that is an n-type semiconductor, and it is a molecule composed entirely of carbon and in the form of hollow sphere or tube. Now, in case of organic semiconductors, it's difficult to control doping. So that's why this organic semiconductors that intensely that used as undoped. Okay, or you can say that they are used as intrinsic semiconductor. So these are certain differences between the normal silicon based electronics, which we are familiar, and the organic electronics. Okay, so in organic electronics, the semiconductors are used as undoped or as intrinsic semiconductors. Okay, now for insulator or for dielectrics, these are some names: polyvinyl alcohol and polymethyl methacrylate, PMMA. Okay, and PVA. These are very chemical names. Okay, so we have seen that some materials they behave as P dot and PSS. They behave as a conductor. Okay, and they are not used for the connection purpose or for the contact purpose. Silver or gold or copper, that is what used for the contact and for connection purpose. We have seen semiconductors, we have seen insulators. Okay. Now these are some recent updates. Okay, that in the list of references, I mentioned two papers, one 2017 paper and one 2019 paper. So I have referred those papers, and that the important information from those papers I have included in the presentation. We will see some of the circuits reported in those papers. So in those circuits, for the metal, they use metal, or you can say actually for conductor, they used Ag nanoparticles, that is the silver, this is silver nanoparticles, ink sintered. Sintered actually, that is a past tense of sinter. Okay, sintering, that is one process which is used for compacting the material. Okay, maybe you can search in the Google to get more information about the sintering process. It provides compactness to the solid mass. Okay, so Ag or silver nanoparticles, ink sintered at low temperatures, offer low resistivity. Low contact resistance between Ag and organic semiconductor, and it results into high performance OTFT devices. So what they found, that if silver nanoparticles are sintered at low temperature, they are offering low resistivity. Okay, and this silver they use for the contact purpose. Okay, and when the silver comes in contact with the organic semiconductor, it results into high performance OTFT, that is organic thin film transistor devices. Even actually in that paper, they investigated copper nanoparticles also. So see that this field that is somewhat connected with the nanoelectronics or nanotechnology also. Okay, copper nanoparticles ink sintered using photonic process. Here they use the temperature actually for the sintering process, and here they use phonons for the sintering process. So basically they tried both silver as well as the copper, but then they concluded that silver gives a better performance, and Whatever the circuits reported in this 2017 paper, there they have used silver nanoparticles sintered at low temperature. Even actually that in that paper, there are some findings related to dielectric materials. In that, they say that cross-linked, that is a process of forming covalent bonds to joint polymer chains. Again, maybe that this is something related to organic chemistry or that chemistry actually. So cross-linked PVP with different polymers, it gives you properties of insolubility, high breakdown strength, and low leakage current. See, what we expect from the dielectric material, first of all, that it should be insoluble, soluble, and it should have high breakdown strength and low leakage current. So in that paper, it is reported that cross-linked PVP with different polymers, it results into insolubility, high breakdown strength, and low leakage current. And I advise maybe that the interested people to report those papers. It's some 20 pages paper, and it's very interesting paper, and maybe you will realize what is the current status of organic electronics. So let us go ahead. Cross-linking is initiated by photonic or thermal reaction. So as I said, actually, you can do cross-linking either using phonons or through thermal reaction. Again, actually, from that, from that paper only, that some important findings I've included in this presentation. It's related to dielectric material. Now, most polymer dielectric materials, they are having a low K, low dielectric constant. Now, if the dielectric constant is low, it's a low actually. K stands for the dielectric constant. If the dielectric constant is low, then the leakage would be higher actually. So you can't use a thinner dielectric material. So now to reduce the leakage, you have to increase the thickness of the dielectric material. Now, if you increase the thickness of the dielectric material, then just you try to recall the MOSFET operation. Now, in MOSFET operation, the dielectric material, it is used between the channel and the gate. And when you apply a gate voltage, a sufficient gate voltage, then the channel is inverted. And once the channel is inverted, if any potential difference is existing between the source and drain, the current will flow actually. So channel gets inverted actually because that you applied the sufficient gate voltage. And that gate voltage effect has to pass through that dielectric material. So now see, in case of organic electronics, that dielectric material, they are having low dielectric constant. And when the dielectric constant is low, then the leakage increases. Now we cannot afford actually to have higher leakage. So to reduce the leakage, what you can do actually, you can use the thicker dielectric material. Now, if you use thicker dielectric material, then the capacitance which will be there between the gate and the channel, that capacitance will reduce. When the capacitance reduces, to have the conduction between the source and drain, you need to apply higher gate voltage. So that's why that in case of the organic electronics, you need higher operating voltage. I think you might have understood. Organic materials, they are suffering from low K, they are suffering from leakage actually. To reduce the leakage, you require thick dielectric. When the dielectric thickness is increasing, for operation of the transistor device, you need to apply more voltage. And that's why the operating voltage in case of the transistor devices realized using organic material, it basically increases, operating voltage increases. Now you may think of that maybe let us use high K dielectric materials. Few high K dielectric choices are available. But the problem is that if you use few maybe that any of that available high K dielectric material, polymer dielectric material, that it is not giving you good interface with the organic semiconductor. Okay, this is it's a material issue actually. Okay, that high-k dielectric materials are available, but they are not having good interface with the organic semiconductor. So they result into cracks, and hence actually they reduce the mobility. Okay, and it also results into hysteresis. Okay, and device instability. So now you have to go with low-k dielectric only. There is no other option actually. Okay, high-k dielectric are available, but when you use high-k dielectric with the organic semiconductor, the interface between the high-k dielectric and organic semiconductor, that is not good. Okay, it results into traps. Okay, and it reduces carrier mobility, and it results into hysteresis, and the device stability, it gets degraded. Now people have tried to find out some solution for that. That let us put actually a low-k dielectric. Okay, between the high-k dielectric and the organic semiconductor. Okay, so that is one option, that inserting low-k dielectric between high-k and this organic semiconductor, it improves the device performance. But see, maybe it's easy to make all these statements, but when you really try to fabricate, then maybe your fabrication process will become complex. And you see, we want to fabricate using this printing method. We don't want to use high-end fabrication technologies. Okay, so you have to use low-k dielectric only. Low-k dielectric leakage is more, so go for thick dielectric. Operating voltage will increase. Few high-k dielectric choices are available, but it will result into traps, and the carrier mobility reduces. It will result into hysteresis. Device instability will device will become unstable. So one solution is that you use low-k dielectric between high-k and organic semiconductor, and it will improve device performance, but then the fabrication will be slightly complex. Okay, so now let us go to the next slide. Now, some of the findings of 2019 paper I have included over here. Here you will realize that this is it's a field of chemical engineers. Okay, but nowadays actually that all this research, it has become multidisciplinary research. Okay, and one has to somewhat that one will need some expertise in various domains, then actually that effective research could be carried out. So in this 2019 paper, they have reported many organic semiconductors, p-type as well as n-type. So p3st and its derivatives, that is that could be used as p-type semiconductor, p-s pentasim, p8 btbt, pb triple t. Okay, it offers mobility 1 cm² upon volt second. This is very less compared to the mobility which is observed in the silicon-based electronics. In silicon-based electronics, mobility is close to 1000, it is observed. Another p-type semiconductor, it is quite complex name, DIF, PES, ABG. Okay, that you can maybe that try to pronounce yourself, DTP, DTC6. Okay, this is stable in the air. It is blended with polystyrene or polymethacrylate, and that improves OTFT. If anybody is interested in this particular domain, what I suggest that one should not work alone actually. Maybe as a team, if one works, then maybe that one can come out with some good, maybe some novel research work, useful research work. Okay, it needs knowledge of chemical engineers, it needs good knowledge of material properties, and of course that electronics also. Now there are some organic semiconductors n-type. These were earlier actually it was not possible, but now people have come out with some solutions for organic semiconductors with EMS n-type. So one solution is that is naphthalene tetracarboxylic limicide, then pterylene tetracarboxylic limicide, then TU3, benzo is diesel-based. Okay, so various, anyway, the three options are available for n-type semiconductors, and many options are available for p-type semiconductors. In 2019 paper, they have used it for anti-semiconductor TU3 basically. Okay, and for p-type semiconductor, I think they want with this particular option. Okay, so let us go ahead. Okay, now let us look at OTFT structure. That is an organic thin film transistor. Now, this is similar to MOSFET, but it is inverted MOSFET. Okay, that yet it is in the bottom part. Okay, source and drain, that is in the bottom part. Okay, so this is gate, this is insulator, this is you can say source, this is drain. Okay, this is semiconductor, and the separation between source and drain, that is a channel length, and the dimension perpendicular to this screen, that is the width of the device. Source and drain, they could be interchanged if the device is symmetric. Okay. Now the gate could be doped with silicon or metal or conducting polymer. Insulator, that could be SiO2, aluminum oxide, silicon nitride, polymer insulator such as polymethacrylate, methyl methacrylate, or polyvinyl phenol. Okay, or some other options which we have seen. Source and drain. High work function metals, gold or silver or copper, that is used actually, or conducting polymer. Till now, I have not seen any paper actually where conducting polymers are used. In majority cases, either silver is used or gold that is used, or copper. It is maybe very rare copper is used. Mostly actually silver or gold it is used. Okay. So, and this particular structure, it is called as a bottom contact, bottom gate, bottom contact structure. There are three structures that we'll see that only 5 minutes is available. I'll show you that structure. Now, this slide, it basically shows the working of the OTFT. Okay, that for various regions, linear region. Okay, that means at the edge of the saturation region and the saturation region. So, see that maybe one. Let me tell you one more thing. This OTFT, it doesn't work in the inversion mode. Okay, so there is no depletion region. This OTFT, it works in the accumulation mode. Okay, so this is not the inversion layer. You should keep in mind actually that this is maybe where I'm putting mouse pointer actually, that is not the inversion layer. Okay, in the next slide, I'll show you that how that conduction takes place actually. Basically, that the bends are maybe that when you apply the gate voltage, the valence bend it gets aligned with the Fermi level of this whatever the metal used in the source and drain. With that, it gets aligned, and if there is any potential difference, then the current will flow. And this current which is flowing, it's basically flow of the carriers. And these carriers are hopping, they are actually jumping. Okay. So there is a different kind of that flow mechanism. It is called as a hopping mechanism. Okay, so OTFT, it doesn't operate in the inversion mode. MOSFET, it operates in the inversion mode. There is a depletion layer. But in case of the OTFT, it operates in the accumulation mode. Okay, so this channel, it is not the inversion layer. This is not the inversion layer actually. That you should keep in mind. Okay, but its characteristic, it is almost the same as the MOSFET. Initially, it will work in the triode mode, and then actually that it will go to the saturation mode. Okay, linear mode or triode mode, and then it will go to the saturation mode. Now, these are various structures of OTFT. One is a bottom contact, top gate. This is same as actually MOSFET. These are source drain. This one is insulator. This is semiconductor. This is substrate, and this is gate actually. Bottom contact, top gate. This is bottom contact, bottom gate, and this is top contact, bottom gate. If you refer that this is a 2017 paper, there same figures are there, and one more actually a structure is shown, and they have given the name says inverted, and then inverted coplanar, staggered coplanar. Those names are given. Okay, so you can refer that paper yourself. Now, bottom contact, bottom gate, that is what the structure is, it is preferred in case of OTFT. The reason is that the charge carriers, they do not have to travel much distance okay, to be part of the conduction layer at the semiconductor dielectric interface. See that when you apply gate voltage, the current which will be flowing, it will be flowing close to this semiconductor insulator interface, and the charge actually, which are there, the carriers which are there in the semiconductor, they don't have to travel too much of distance, okay, to become the part of that conduction layer. Okay, so otherwise actually that again the frequency of operation it may get affected. So that's why this bottom contact, bottom gate structure, that is what preferred. Okay, bottom contact top gate and top contact bottom gate, charge carriers have to travel tens of nanometers to be part of conduction layer. That is one of the drawbacks. Of course, they have some other advantages. Okay, so that maybe you can refer yourself, but this structure, that is what preferred, bottom contact bottom gate. Bhavesh bhai, we are at 6 o'clock, so
oh, sir, okay, so you just conclude the session and then we arrange some questions, sir.
Okay, so I'll quickly run through the slide. This,
okay,
this particular slide actually, that is for the energy band diagram, and as I said actually, that the center part actually, that is the energy band diagram for the semiconductor, and two sides metal regions are there. You can say source and drain, and when the VT is less than zero, then the valence band, it gets aligned with the Fermi level, okay, and through hopping mechanism, the charge carriers are flowing, or you can say actually current will be flowing, and the gap with let me tell you, HOMO stands for highest occupied molecular orbit, LUMO stands for lowest unoccupied molecular orbit. LUMO actually is same as you can say conduction band, and the HOMO actually is same as the valence band. And the gap between the LUMO and this Fermi level, it is more actually. So that's why that it's difficult to realize n-type device. Okay, and it's possible to realize p-type device. Through valence band, the current is flowing. Through HOMO, the current is flowing. Okay. If you want a current to flow through LUMO, then that the device will show the behavior of the n-channel MOSFET. Okay, or n-channel OTFP. But the difference between the LUMO and Fermi level, that is more. Okay, but nowadays that problem it is solved actually. Partly it is solved. Now, this maybe I think you can, just now what I said actually, it is mentioned over here that you can read yourself. I will share entire presentation with Bhavesh bhai and he may circulate. This is some OTFP history. This is charge transport in organic material. Okay, and see, in case of organic materials, its mobility it is increasing with increasing temperature. The reason is actually that transport is phonon assisted. That is, in case of the silicon based electronics, if you increase the temperature, mobility decreases. Okay, even if in case of organic materials, the mobility increases with the increase in the electric field. This is opposite actually. Okay, that compared to that silicon based electronics. And OTFP, it works in the accumulation mode, no depletion layer. This is the characteristic. You can see actually this is the problem. That RGBS characteristic, and here the problem is, okay, the problem is partly solved in the recent research work. This is a better IDS versus VDS characteristic. This is a CMOS inverter, and you can see actually there is hysteresis. Forward traversing and the reverse traversing, we are not getting the same characteristics. That is one of the problems. This is a D flip flop with the organic that material or organic devices. Okay, and it functions quite well. This is op amp, and its magnitude characteristics. These are various circuit design styles using which are reported for the organic electronics. You can read yourself. This is about analog circuit design. Important parameters are transconductance and visiting frequency. Okay, so about that it is mentioned, as well as common mode feedback and VTH variation. Then RFID, it has lots of applications, and as organic electronics, it's low cost electronics. It is this is one area where organic electronics has lots of scope. RFID classification, that you can read yourself. This is about RFID, that various frequencies and active capacity. This is 135 kilo RFID. This is 13.56 kilo mega RFID. 900 mega RFID. 2.4 gigahertz RFID. Miniaturization in RFID. You will be surprised in that in 2019, some researchers at Bristol University successfully glued RFID micro transponders to live ants in order to study their behavior. Okay, that on the ant they glued RFID and they wanted to study the behavior of ants. Okay, so to that level, the technology is advanced. And the chip size of RFID, that is 0.05 mm cross 0.05 mm using SOI process. This is just that RFID using SOI. Basically, chips would be there, straps would be there, and antenna would be there. After this is regarding cost of the RFID. This is one paper, that 2007 paper, where RFID, OTFP-based RFID was studied and it was reported, fabricated, tested, various characteristics. This is the inverter using OTFP-based RFID, that zero VGS load and diode load inverter. This is a deep flip-flop. Okay, and this is basically that how can we read it? RFID tag. So one is a capacitive mechanism, and another one is that inductive mechanism. Okay, that capacitive tag, or you can say inductive tag. Capacitive tag, that is what preferred actually. Okay, or inductive coupling, or that capacitive coupling. This is the circuit diagram where the code of the RFID actually that is shown. This I request all of you to read it yourself. Then. Okay. This is regarding display technology. This display, it was developed by Sony, and you can see it could be bent actually. Okay. And it is using organic devices. This is in the previous slide, there was a 550 metric display and can be bent to a radius of curvature 5 mm. And this is summary. And there are various opportunities in this field. One can work at the material level. Okay, one can work on improving device performance. One can work on structure and device optimization. There are so many fabrication issues. Even modeling, that also one can work on. And circuit design issues one can work on. Okay, that simulation tools are not available, so one can work to develop simulation tools. So that is, I think that's the last slide. Okay, and few backup slides are there, but let us close the presentation. Okay, so from my side, it's over.
Thank you, sir, for sharing such a good information regarding organic electronics with very small smart.
Yeah, Neha, please continue.
Thank you so much, sir. I would like to request all the participants and panel members to turn on their camera so that we can take the screenshot.
Sir, please stop sharing the screen so that we can get the cameras proper.
Will I turn on my camera?
Yes, sir. Turn on your camera and stop the sharing.
Okay. Just let me see that. Okay. Thank you very much.
Yeah. All students are requested to turn on your camera. And faculty as well.
Sir, is it done?
Just 1 minute, ma'am.
Sure.
ओके ओके थैंक यू.
Thank you so much, sir. So, honorable and respected Dr. Hemal Shah and Professor Dharmesh Darji, valuable staff members and invited students, it is my privilege to offer thanks on this occasion. I, Professor Neha Rajput, on behalf of my entire organization, would like to express our sincere thanks to today's speaker and expert, Dr. R.A. Thakur, for giving the best knowledge about the topic and showing the gratitude for exposing his theory for the same. We are all inspired by your great words, sir. Now, for the participants, a quiz link will be shared in the chat window. So all are requested to go through that and attend the quiz. Okay. And I would like to end up this session here. And thank you again for your time and support.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you, Thakur sir.
Thank you so much.
Please keep in touch. And thank you, we are looking forward to meet you in person as well.
Sure, I'll be happy.
Students, please be here with this link. Just a second, just a moment.
So, guys, taking your leave, I have to join other meetings. So, please allow me to go. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Can I quit or that to continue?
Just a second, sir. Just 1 minute.
If anybody has any question, that I'll try my best to answer.
Yes, sir. So, am I audible?
Yeah, perfectly audible.
Yeah. So I have seen, gone through the presentation. You said that we are not doping these organic semiconductors. So much the conductivity matter will be there.
Actually, it's difficult to control doping in case of organic semiconductor. Hmm. Okay. And that's why that it basically uses undoped. Okay. Inversion, basically that inversion layer actually that is not developed in this the device operation. Okay, that how do we operate the device? By applying the gate voltage, we align the valence band or conduction band with the Fermi level of the metal. And if the voltage difference exists between the source and drain, then you will get the current flow actually. Okay, what? So that is how actually the conduction is made possible.
Okay, sir.
Just a second. Now, student, you can turn on your camera. I will take one more time selfie. Yeah. Yes, all the students. Now you can turn on your camera.
One more problem with this OTFT device is that you can't adjust threshold voltage. The way you adjust threshold voltage in case of the silicon based device, by adjusting doping, you can control, you can vary threshold voltage. Mm. So, whereas in case of OTFT device, threshold voltage adjustment through doping, that is not possible. Mm.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Yes, all the students, please turn on your camera. Just 1 minute. Yes, Ashil, Jeet, Parth, Priyanshi. Okay, guys, thank you.
I want to ask the question. I can also ask. Sir, can any student?
Yes, student can unmute themselves.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes.
Sir, do we see the near future where, you know, organic electronics are head to head in competition with our regular semi, silicon based electronics?
Only for that, wherever the cost is the driving factor. Okay, that the applications such as RFID, okay, or maybe large area applications, okay, there and wherever that maybe, you need rapid prototyping, there I think maybe organic electronics would be giving a tough competition to the silicon based electronics. But wherever that performance matters in terms of that speed, okay. There, I think maybe organic electronics is very, very far compared to the silicon based electronics. The reason is actually that see, mobility that is very less. Okay, the drain current, the current will be proportional to mobility. So it will be 1,000 times lesser current. And to the current, same as that silicon based device, you need to increase the weight. Now, when you increase the weight, the device capacitance will increase. Okay, so that maybe you can't say that organic electronics it can actually completely replace the silicon based electronics. But of course, actually, that is this RFID, and there are many other applications, sensor applications, healthcare applications, wherever you will be needing mechanical flexibility. Okay, and wherever that will be requiring low temperature, there I think silicon based electronics can be replaced with the organic. Based electronics.
Thank you, sir. My question was beautifully answered by you. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.
Any other student want to ask the question?
I request each of you actually at least read those two papers, that's the 2017 paper and 2019 paper. You will get a very good idea of where the organic electronics is currently. Current status, I am saying, current 2-3 years old, actually, it's not very old at all. Okay, that's particularly 2019 paper, Science Direct paper. It's a very well written paper and it will give you very good information, excellent information about what is the current status of the organic electronics. And one journal elsewhere is running on organic electronics. Dedicated journal on the organic electronics. And somewhere you will find this difficult to read also, because that lots of complex terminology would be there. Chemical materials would be there. Okay, any other question anybody is having?
Any student or any faculty, if you have any question or whatever, you can ask.
And maybe as an maybe that to department or to institute, I suggest that maybe that this subject one should think of offering. Okay, that this is a new upcoming field. Maybe that after maybe some years there will be some requirement in this field. Okay, and maybe you, maybe to all faculty also, I suggest that you should explore that. Can you develop a laboratory, organic electronics laboratory in your department? You can avail some funding, maybe from Government of India or from Government of Gujarat. Okay, so that's possible actually. Okay, so that is what you should maybe once you have become familiar with this particular subject. You should see that how you can contribute in this subject. Well, you should think of developing laboratories, and if any help is required from my side, MIT it is having dedicated laboratory in organic electronics. Okay, I think it is called as a one. They have given a very good name, one O-N-E, one laboratory. O stands for organic. N stands for nanostructure. E stands for engineering. Organic and nanostructure engineering laboratory, something like that, actually, there. One laboratory. IIT Kanpur, they are having excellent facilities in organic electronics. Even IIT Bombay is having. IIT Bangalore, it would be surely having. Okay. IIT Jodhpur, there is a professor, Tiwari, he works in organic electronics. Okay, in Gujarat, maybe that, as per my knowledge, very few professors might be familiar with this particular subject. One may be Professor Sanjay Prajapati, I think. He has somewhat worked in organic electronics. And maybe Professor, maybe, I'm not sure actually, Professor N.M. Devasu. Okay. Not too many professors that. Okay, but this field one should explore. Okay, that research work might be difficult. Okay, because you may need to work at material level that will slightly difficult. Okay, but maybe that you can have a laboratory. Okay, you can offer this subject even at an undergraduate level also. It should be offered. Maybe. Okay, and at PG level it should be surely offered. Okay, so can I tweet or that maybe if anybody has any query that I'll try my best to answer. I have not made any contribution in this domain, but I've just done the reading. Okay, and I'm making people aware that I might have delivered maybe 8 to 10 talks on organic electronics in various institutes. And it needs minimum 3 hours. Okay, and
yes,
some board work is also required. Everything can't be taught through online teaching. Okay.
Very valuable time and give us the idea about introduction section as well as some recent trend and some new publications idea. Yeah, I will share your presentation to the students as well as the faculty, those who want to obtain more knowledge regarding this organic electronics. Okay, so Tejaswari, is anything is missing or shall we leave?
Yes, sir, I can stop the session. Yeah, thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.